In the Clavers lab at the Hubrecht Institute, we have for the first time been able to grow snake venom gland cells in the lab using organoid technology. Snakebite kills more than 100,000 people every year and disables even more. At the moment, to obtain snake venom, snakes have to be caught or bred and then milked. This is a very intense and difficult process. To obtain snake venom is very important to produce anti-venom or to study snake venom composition to use for therapeutics.
So we were wondering if we can improve this process by growing mini organs off the snake venom gland. For that, we got eggs of various different species of snakes, we got the glands out and we isolated the stem cells and tried to grow them as mini organs. First, we saw that they didn't grow at 37 degrees because snakes are cold-blooded, so we had to lower the temperature to 32 degrees to make them grow. So this is different, but what's very similar, and that was one of the big discoveries of the study, is that a lot of the growth factors we need for mouse and for human are also required for the snake, and in fact, we can use the human growth factors to grow a snake venom gland.
Venom is a very complex mixture of toxins, and it was not known if different cell types contribute to different parts of the venom or if one cell can actually make everything in the venom. So using single-cell RNA sequencing, in which we can look at what every cell type produces, we found that different cell types actually produce different compounds, and it's just not one cell that can make everything. To confirm these findings in organoids in an actual venom gland, we stained multiple toxins. In green you can see one example of such a toxin which is only expressed on one side of the gland, whereas the other side of the gland barely makes any of this toxin. So this really confirms this heterogeneity that we discovered in organoids.
What's great about the organoids is that every single cell is a factory for making toxins, and we can expand the organoids as much as we like. So we think in the future, instead of milking snakes, we may be milking the organoids. We could already show that when we take toxins from our organoids and add them to muscle cells, they stop firing, which is similar to being paralyzed by an actual snake bite.
Now that we can grow snake venom gland cells in the lab and produce the venom, there are many applications that we can think of. For example, better understanding of the biology of the venom gland, to understand how snakes produce and secrete their venom and how different factors influence that process. For example, age and food intake. Now that we know organoid technology works for reptile cells, we can think of other animals with unique biological capabilities to study in the lab using organoids. We can expand the organoids and produce venom in the lab. This can be useful for anti-venom production or to study the composition for therapeutics.